for the invitation. I came from Warren, that is a little town. I traveled yesterday from 6 hours driving, so a little bit tired after work. Before coming here, I think that I'm going to come back. Anyway, I think that we are trying to put together too many dates and 75 percentage of application, too much numbers. I just want to encourage everybody to just gather the information and send the application, and that's it. Don't feel pressed that you have to achieve 75 points in the immigration list or whatever. So just do the job and that's it. My case, it was a little bit interesting. I never studied English. I never. I just learned by reading, watching videos. My English, one year and 4 months when I came here, was terrible. I improved a lot with my friends, the real Aussies, if I can say that. They have different slangs, and I have many slangs, and you really feel the experience while you are in a regional area. So I really like to encourage everybody to go to a regional area, because you will find really nice people that you go into the street and you say, hey, how are you? And they're going to say, I'm good, and you? And it's not the case like here. Anyway, I'm really pissed off for that, because people here is not, it's not polite. you can go fishing. Anything here in Australia is easy. So my goal is to work as an engineer. And when I get my PR, I hope to achieve that goal. When I came here, I went to Dobbo. That is it's the biggest regional area. The biggest country town in New South Wales. It's around 130,000 people in population. Mainly, there is a factory of pet food, and there is another factory that they process lambs. You know the lambs. A little bit sad story. It's like 7,000 lambs every day. So you have to see blood, and it's really hard work. It's a really hard work. It's 11 hours, you never can stop, never can sit. I was farting, I lose a lot of weight. it was amazing, because you interact with different cultures, Pakistanis, Hindus. I have met people from everywhere. And you talk with them, you have a lunch with them, and you're in the same boat with them. After that, I got employment opportunity with, I'm talking about the story, but there is a regional area that you apply that is going to be like the regional development office that is called Orana. It's the region that I'm working in. That they begin to send you like mails. Oh, there is an opportunity here. You can apply here and just apply. And it's a construction project. It's the first in the world. That is, they process the tires and they get an oil and they sell that to the Navy here in Australia. I'm working like a tradie, kinda. An electrician sometimes, and yeah, anyway. It's good because you can go with the Australian, everybody is Australian. I just met three Colombians and two Peruvians in Dobbo. That's it, just five people from Latin America. It's really amazing experience. And besides of that, there is no ceiling, so if the regional, give you the green light, like, okay, we need this person in this region, you have a lot of chances to get the the visa in 3 months. Yeah, with 60 points. What was my case? I was so I was 15 points. I was 30 points, 27 years old, 26. And I got the 6 Finnish band of the IELTS, so I got the 10, so it was 40. And after that, outside of Australia, I just met this condition, that it was 5 points, so it was 45. And the 10 points that gave me the 489, that it was 65 points. 60 points. Yeah, I don't know. I think that I get 5 points more somewhere. Anyway, the point is that I present my application with 60 points, and I got my visa in 3 months.
3 months.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, you said that you got points with your IELTS or not?
Yeah, 0 points. Yeah, 0 points. Oh. That's why maybe the math.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
I missed that. Yeah, I got 0 points in the IELTS. Anyway, but it's a requirement. You have to get the 6 in Engineers Australia to test your degree, and your 6 in immigration if you want to apply. It's really difficult. Or tricky, the regional, because depending on the way that you want to go, they ask you more IELTS. For example, if you want to go to South Australia, to Adelaide, you have to have at least, most of the engineers, they require 7.
7 points, yeah.
7 in the
IELTS, or equivalent, yeah.
But you need like the overall, or
each band?
Each band.
Each band.
Yeah.
So I have a friend, for example, that he applied 7 times. For example, the first time he applied, he got the speaking 5. And the next time the reading was 5 or 6 and so on. And never all the bands were 6 or more.
Oh,
but there is something interesting that Milton told us last time, that you can use 2 IELTS or 2 PTE to show the bands, and they that complement each other.
Is that really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
I can
have
7 in listening and reading and 8
and you got another IELTS, you got better scoring another one, so you can combine them and then you show them.
So I get my 8. Okay.
Oh, that's why you take the general or the academic IELTS?
Doesn't matter. Only PTE has to be academic, and this is the only option actually they have for PTE, but IELTS could be general or academic.
But the academic IELTS is a little bit
hard.
Yeah, I got the academic.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Take the academic if you're going to a university for a bachelor or master, but otherwise don't take it. It's a little bit harder.
Okay.
The readings and the writing is harder.
And not the writing.
did you find hard finding a job in this new small?
No, just 1 week. I arrived from Sydney on February 24, 2017,
mm-hmm.
And just 1 week, I got the job.
1 week.
In the abattoir.
Yeah.
The abattoir is the lamb.
And you got your visa in 3 months. You apply?
Yeah, and I get the visa in 3 months.
Yeah, so he applied the 15th of September, and in December he got the visa.
Yeah, I was lighting the velitas, you know. I was saving in Colombia. Yeah.
A question, man. Why did you choose that region? Because you have more opportunities
because
to get the visa, or
because my IELTS. So, for example, you go to South Australia and they require 7, and you go to Tasmania, I think that is the same. And I want to be in Sydney soon, so I say like I'm going to look the biggest country town near to Sydney, and it was double.
Okay. Is there any way that you can see, okay, here in this region we need more engineers, so maybe it could be easier for you to be there? Maybe revise English? I don't know. I suppose
no,
I need more engineers there.
You just submit all the documents that the office require.
Mm-hmm.
They have all the documents, and if they give you like a letter and say like, hey, we're going to sponsor you to come here to this region, so they talk with the immigration and they say, hey, we need this guy here, and that's why is the process
and
nominated.
Can I do it with many regions, regionals? Like, can
no,
I do it with
only one.
Only one.
Only one
at a time. Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I have a friend that he's an electrical engineer too. He was working with me in Double, but he moved to South Australia, and he asked, and they say that if you are nominated in Double in New South Wales, you can move to another regional after you get the visa. As soon as you comply with the 2 years living and working in at least 1 year in a regional area for 38 hours.
Do you pay a lawyer or you did by yourself?
Everything by myself.
Okay.
Because I get a quote for the lawyers, whatever, and they ask me for 5,000 American dollars.
Wow.
5,000
yeah, he did everything, all the process from Colombia.
Ah, yeah, besides.
That's important to say that he did everything from Colombia.
Okay, the first thing is that you just have to do all the essays with the Engineers Australia, and they give you the letter and everything, and it's really important to have the all the documents, because they give you 28 days to submit the documents. If they give you an invitation and in 28 days you don't submit the documents, they're going to ban you and you can apply for a visa for I don't know how many years. So that's why it's important to gather all the all the documents, because you don't know when you're going to get the invitation. Could be like 3 months, 1 month,
1 year.
Year.
So you were 60 days. In this one, it's 28.
When I was presenting my
invitation? Yeah,
60.
60. And in his case, it was 28.
When I was presenting my paperwork, it was 28. But I don't know if they changed the dates.
Probably because it's a different visa.
Yeah, it's a regional.
Yeah.
And you have 3 months or 4 months, I'm not sure, if you are offshore, I mean like out of Australia, to move to that regional. You have 4 months.
Yeah.
Oh.
If you are in Australia, you have 1 month to move to that regional.
Oh, wow.
You lose your visa.
No, you don't lose your visa, but when you're going to get the PR, they're going to
check.
Probably you're going to get the PR or something. I don't know.
It doesn't mean that you have to move, but it doesn't mean that you are going to find a job there.
Doesn't mean, yeah.
Doesn't
mean. Okay, so move to that part about the job.
But did you do the regional?
But there are plenty of jobs. For example, picking cotton. There are many backpackers. They travel around Australia just looking for those jobs. Now we are in the season of cotton, so there are picking cotton or cotton gin. The cotton gin is that when they process all the cotton and they dry all the cotton.
People
and
yeah.
Can work, like, okay,
and they
so
pay,
I go
they
the
pay you like...
You don't have to work as engineer.
Yeah.
Okay,
no.
Oh, yeah, you can sell lollipops.
You just have to.
Yeah. Yeah. That doesn't matter. As soon as you work at least 38 hours every week, I mean like full time, for 1 year.
In everything.
You need proof you're working in the countryside.
You have to live there in whatever place you're in.
You have to show them that you
and
live.
And after you work 1 year there, you have to live 1 year. So yeah, at least you spend 2 years in living there. I have so many friends that they say like, oh, but I have my Aussie friend that I can put that I'm living on his address and I can move to another place and get a job paying cash. And yeah, you can do it.
Yeah.
There are many ways to do it. In Colombia, they always find
don't talk about things that you shouldn't do.
Can you share after the list of documents you were asked after the invitation?
Okay, I'm really organized,
it doesn't have to be
and I
day.
Send
yeah.
all all the documents that I put. So, for example, I send my all the letters from the companies. I send all the.
It's the same pack you sent to Indonesia. Australia, you send again.
To request the nomination.
No, after. When you get the invitation, you have a really short period to present everything.
All the documentation that you said that you, for example, when you apply for the expression of interest, you have to show up everything that you put there.
Yeah. Okay, it's the same. Yeah.
It's the same.
The same.
Yeah. Okay.
Just all the documents.
Okay.
Like, for example, if you say that you have 7 in IELTS, you have to show up that.
Okay.
If not, they're going to cancel the invitation.
Got it.
I sent all the documentation, and then I wait for the nomination, that it was pretty short, you see? So I get my paperwork from Engineer Australia. I submit the application on August. I wait for the nomination, and the invitation I received on September. So it was
3 months.
And then they asked me the Form 80. The Form 80 is that one form that you have to specify everything that you have done. So for example, I study my high school, and then I rest for 6 months.
You tell like your resume, like
vacation, but you have to show all the spaces that you have in your life, all the spaces. All the spaces.
Okay.
It's like a.
You need to
something there. Anyway, that's it. That's my experience. I just encourage everybody, if you want to go to a regional area, don't get afraid that you're not going to get a job. There are plenty of jobs. Even there is a good job that they pay like $1,500 every week. That is with old people, working with old people, or people with disabilities.
Age care.
So, it's amazing. For example, you go there and you sleep, and they pay you for sleep.
Overnight.
They pay you overnight.
Not bad.
Nobody have any questions or something?
Why not?
The assessment documents basically is the essays. The essays is something that, for example, what is an essay? An essay is that, okay, I'm an electrical engineer. I have to show that I'm planning and designing power station and power generation equipment. So I go there and say like, I was in a project that required an installation of an equipment, blah, 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 blah. And you have to do like an essay, but with your life.
Yes.
So it's 3 episodes, so you have to tell all the story, but taking into account all this information. So they're going to say like, he's an electrical engineer, yeah.
And for your experience, the letter and
the letters,
the taxes, or
the superannuation.
Superannuation
and the taxes. Yeah, I have plenty of documents.
But anyways, don't be afraid of calling them directly or going to their offices, because what I did was like, anything wasn't clear for me in the website, I just call them. The experience is valid from the moment I graduated or before. They say straight away, no, from the moment you graduated.
Australia.
Yeah.
Or you can send emails. I think that emails is better, because you spend like 1 hour on the phone and
Engineers Australia, they're really friendly. I don't know how is ACS for IT engineers.
Mine was just very easy. I just had to submit the documents and paper it and just wait.
Did you have to write down any essay?
No
essay. So only for Engineers Australia. I don't know for the.
But you have to do it.
Only that's one thing, because I finished the bachelor.
Oh yes.
I did assessment ACS and it's not as complex as we can.
Yeah, exactly.
Really?
No. Obviously, you have to have all the letters from
yeah.
the employers, but you don't need to prove your taxes or your subordination or your insurance. No, you don't need that. They have like a structure in order to have a correct letter from your employer. Pretty much that's
with
it.
ACS.
ACS.
ACS, yes. That's only for
ACS,
IT.
ACS, for IT.
Yeah,
IT. It's for,
yes,
yeah, it's for IT. And Beta says that is the one Karen is applying.
Yeah.
Is going to apply for?
Maybe. Yeah, you need to do the SS and the essays with them. But now that I started reading the requirements with them, it's like a, they are, you can pay to get help from them. So they said if you paid us for that, so you can do your essays, we can
assist you.
Assist you. Until the moment that you apply for, so,
so
I don't know how works exactly because I need to share my experience with more people who already did that. I'm not pretty sure about the process with them. I'm just started the process with them.
Anyway, but you can look that on Google. So, for example, I don't know if my assistant can help me. On Google, MSA booklet.
Ah, yeah, the booklet. There is a booklet.
The booklet for Engineers Australia is already in the group.
Ah, yes.
So you can check for Engineers Australia. We are gonna try to get the one for ACS, for BetaSES and everything.
No, like in our process, I'm a psychologist in Brazil, and I can get plus 5 points in our process because psychology is in the skill field. In the skill list, but the process for organized is ridiculous. Like I will spend a lot of money and I have to get 7 in IELTS tests and do a specific technical test for prove my skills. So it's like for 5 points.
No, for the
not
specific.
Yeah, like
very hard.
Felipe is applying as an environmental
engineer.
Yeah. And you were trying to get 5 more points
in psychology,
as a partner, but it's not easy.
But the process is so hard. So we're like, easier to translate some documents.
How much do you
want
these 5 points?
There's something like, yeah, you spend a lot of money in IELTS and with these tests, and the process is very hard. It's easier to get the invitation before get my 5 points. So. Depends, you have to check if the work will be. You look like, oh, 5 points. And when you see the process, say, oh, no. I don't care, it's 5 points. So let's do something different.
Yeah, but anyways, in Endurance Australia, you find the booklet, and all the people, for example, you study overseas, is different pathway. So you have to check exactly what is the pathway you are applying for. In your case, for example, the pathway is different because you did your bachelor degree here.
It was easier.
But, yes, but if it was overseas, I think it's the session C, if I'm not wrong. The session C, assessment of non-accredited qualifications engineer and manager. And it depends on the pathway you're applying. For example, if you're applying as engineer manager or just engineer professional. They have 3 different pathways. Professional engineer, engineering technologist, or engineer associate, or engineering manager. So in my case, I applied with professional engineer. But normally, if you did your degree overseas, it's session C. All the session C. I recommend you to read the decision.
Yeah, just give a look on the booklet. Everything is really descriptive. There are some ways that you can avoid the episodes. For example, if you have one of these, for example, university have one of these accords. My university, I thought that it was with the Washington Accord. I was happy because I avoid the essay, but I sent an email to Engineers Australia to verify that, and they say that they have it's not an accord itself, it's just like a, it's not the accord 100%, it's just like a, something related. Anyway, I had to use the, I had to do the essays, but it's really descriptive. Just give a look and It's easy. Everything is there, everything. How to present the letters, how to present the essays, how many words in the essays, the parts of the essays, everything is there. If you have any, you want to know something, just post something on the Facebook, and maybe we can give some help.
That's the idea of the Facebook group, that help each other and share information we are getting. Like in this meeting, that many people have different points of view and information they have got. So yeah, we can share everything and maybe we can build up or improve this presentation and this document and have something official for everyone. And the idea that, okay, this time was for Engineers Australia. I don't know if next time someone for ACS can share how they got how they did the process. Also for Beta CES. So that's the idea, to help and get to do it. And also to get someone for the how to go for the essays for Engineers Australia, like giving tips and everything. So that's the idea, to help each other, networking, everything. That's the idea of the group.
Okay, thank you for the attention. Do you have any question or something so far? We're good?
Thank you so much for your time.